Hi everyone, this is Sam here. Can you guys hear me? Hello? Can you guys hear me? Is it? Yeah, it's clear, right? Okay. Okay. I'm using a new headphone, that's why I wanted to check if it's working or not. Okay, so shall we start? We have 8. I guess that should be okay. Someone says voice. Narasimha, can you hear me now? Narasimha, can you hear me? Narasimha, you can talk. Nobody banned you from talking. Yeah, Narasimha, please don't connect to through laptop. It's better if you all connect through phone, if you use the dial-in number on the GoToMeeting. Someone else says no voice. Okay, I'll remove the headphones then. Hello? Sir, go bete. Sir, no bete. Narasimha, can you hear me now? Hello? Okay, even Satish is unable to hear me. Are you guys able to hear me now? I'm on speaker. I removed my headphones. Satish, can you hear me now? I'm able to hear. Sudhir is able to hear. Good. So Satish and Narasimha, please confirm if you guys are able to hear me or not. Only if you guys are able to hear, I'll start the class. Okay, so rest of the guys, you can hear me, right? Just give me 2 or 3 guys, just tell me if you can hear me or not. If 2 or 3 guys can hear, I'll start.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
This is good, I'm able to hear.
Okay, good. Okay then. Okay then, anyways, I'll go and start the class. So, these are, voice is not audible. Okay. Okay. I'll do one thing. I'll disconnect and I'll call back. Let's see if it works then.
Please enter your access code followed by password. Audio pin followed by the pound.
Hello guys, Sam. Can you guys hear me now? Can you guys hear me now?
Yeah, actually, if they join on the phone call only, we can.
Yeah, that's true. I hope everyone's on phone call rather than being on GoToMeeting audio.
Okay.
Okay, anyways, let's go ahead and start. We're almost 5 minutes into past 6. So until now, we've seen what are the process we have and UI walkthrough of our NetSuite instance. Where we've seen all setups like personal, company and accounting, and then we've seen custom forms. So today let's see what are custom fields, columns, lists, tabs and records. So since we've seen custom forms last time, for example this is an invoice form, and I've shown you how to move fields from one place to other, like on the main or from main to the tabs. I mean, these are called subtabs. These are not tabs, because we consider these are tabs, like activities, payments, transactions. These are the tabs, and subtabs are all these items, billing, shipping. These are all subtabs. And what else I've shown you, like how you put the column break and how you create new field groups, and then yeah, it's just playing around with the form. Yeah, Satish?
No, you haven't seen the screen.
Oh, sorry, guys. Sorry. Good catch. Okay, that's good. Now, hopefully, you guys should be able to see my screen. Can you guys see my screen now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. So, yeah, this is the invoice form. I've showed you guys how to move fields from one place to other within the form, and how to adjust, like, replace, create the order within the fields, like move the field up or down using the customized form, right? Okay, now let's see what are fields in itself. So there are two kinds of fields. One are standard fields and one are custom fields. So when NetSuite provides subscription, we take it, clients take it, and we create a custom invoice form out of a standard invoice form, we'll just have all basic standard forms, standard fields. So, for example, look at this customer. This is a standard field. How to determine, how to differentiate between standard and custom fields? Simple. Just click on the field label and look at the internal ID. So, whenever the internal ID doesn't start with CUST, it's a standard field. Whenever a field internal ID stands with CUST, CUST, that's a custom field. So, this customer is a standard field. Look at date. Even this is a standard field. Client date is internal ID. Invoice. So most of these are standard fields. So let's see if we can find any custom field over here. Look at this premium invoice test status too. Look at this CUST body. So whenever a field internal ID starts with CUST, it's a custom field. Okay. And standard fields are inbuilt, pre-built by NetSuite. They come with the subscription. They are always there. We don't create the standard fields. Okay. And custom fields are such that we create them. So we create all custom fields. And how do we create a custom field? So we come to customization, lists, records, and fields. And within this, we have different kinds of fields. You can see entity fields, item fields, CRM fields, transaction body fields. And at the bottom, you can even see, okay, transaction column fields. We'll look into it later. Column fields we'll look at later. First, we'll see what are basic fields. So we have entity field, entity, item, CRM, transaction body fields, item number fields, and other custom fields. So first, let's look each one of them. First, we have entity fields. Okay, what are entity fields? Let's open one. So this is how the field definition, the field record. This is a field record. And we can find all field records at customization, list, record fields, and all the fields, different field pages. So whenever you try to create a new custom field, you provide the label. That's how it appears on the forms. And then you have the internal ID. See here, it starts with CUST CUST. Since it's an entity field, you can see CUST entity. It starts with CUST entity. And then you can give the description of what kind of field you're creating. Make sure you always select this store value. If you don't select store value, you'll create a field, but you can't enter a value in that. So since you need to enter a value in the field, you always need to check this store value. And show in list, if you want to see this in search or view, then you need to click this show in list. And then here, look here, applies to. So what are entity fields? Entity fields are those fields which are set on customer form, project form, vendor form, employee form, or some contact form, partner. These are on all these forms. You can set these fields, and these are called entity fields. And you give put all the details, okay, and applies to. Since it's an entity field, it's not certain that it goes to each and every entity. We can certainly give select here all entities, but it's up to us. It can even be set on just one entity, or a couple of entities, or all entities. So you need to make sure whenever you're creating an entity field or any field, okay, exactly on what all forms, what all records does it need to be set. So this entity, this test ended custom field, custom entity field is currently set on employee record. Okay, that's all under applies to. So on which record is this field going to be? That should be selected under applies to. And then we have display step, display. Okay, what is display? Insert before. So on employee form, we have this field. We are going to create this field. And on the employee form, where do you want to place it? This is just an option. It's just optional. You can select a value or not. If you want to place this before any of these fields, just you need to select that. If you want to test end date to be placed before company size, just select company size, insert before. Okay. And then sub tab. On employee record, you have tabs, sub tabs, right? If you want, you can directly create this field on the sub tabs. If you don't select any sub tabs, by default, it will go into custom tab, I mean custom sub tab. There are a lot of sub tabs here. Okay. Then display type, always make sure it's normal so that you can just enter, anybody can enter value in the field. Inline text is something where you can't enter manually. Only through scripts or workflows you can set value to these fields that are inline text. Disabled, these fields, the field value, people cannot see the field value. There will be just a field name, that's it. You can't see the field value. That's when it's called disabled. You can't even enter, you can't see what's in the field. But you'll see the field label. And hidden is where you can't even see the field label. So complete field label or field name or the field value, everything will be hidden. It will be just in the background. So that's when you select hidden. And help, nothing. If you want to type anything, you can. If you want to put any information, you can put on the help. Next, validation and defaulting. So if you want this field to be mandatory, like everybody, whenever they come on employee form, they have to certainly they have to put a test end date. That's when you select this field to be mandatory. If you select mandatory, everybody when someone is editing or creating an employee form, they certainly have to provide a date to this field. If they don't provide date and they try to click save, they'll get an error saying you need to please enter all the mandatory fields. So that is mandatory. And check spelling, this is not required. Check this box to enable the spell check function for this field. Normally you never come across using this such fields. Okay, default value, if you want to select any default value, a default static value, you're not changing it, then you can select here. And dynamic default, under this, like for example, this is used mostly for date. So whenever you're creating a record, I mean you're creating a customer or something, and you want, whenever you're creating it at that particular on that particular date or the particular time when you're creating, you want that value, you can just select this current date and time. So whenever an employee record is created, don't put this mandatory. So when an employee record is created or updated, this field will be set to current date and time. So that's why it's called dynamic default. And search field, don't worry about all this. And then sourcing and filtering. Okay, what is sourcing? Let's go to any form. Okay, we have a general form here. Okay, so sourcing is based upon one field value, another field gets set. That is called sourcing. For example, if you are not this one, let's look at any other. Let's look at invoice form. That's better. Okay, so based up here we can select. Okay, when you select a customer, okay, and based upon the customer value, some other field has to be set. That's where you do sourcing. And for sourcing to happen, the source field, it should be a record. For example, customer is a record itself, right? Invoice is a separate record and customer is a separate record. So you select any customer here. Let's select any customer. Okay, I don't know about. So when you select a customer, this customer, there is a record, the customer record with this name, right? So from that customer record, based upon that customer record, any field on that customer record, we'll get that field value and we'll set somewhere here. For example, location. On customer record, we may have a field called location. Okay, on that location, we have same values, CA, SFO, NY, and MA. And if there's a value selected on that CA, on that location field on customer, and over here you want the same value to be set in this location. So if you want this location value to be same as it is on customer, on this customer, I don't know about, on this, then what we do is on this location, for example, this is currently okay. This is a custom field. That's fine. So for this, there is one criteria. That is the source field, the source source record field. So on the customer record, the customer RN about record, if we have a location field, that field data type, it should be same as the custom field over here, the destination custom field. It should be same data type. And how we select sourcing? Let me show you an example. Let's try this one, test ended. Okay, this test ended is on employee, right? Okay, so employee ID, no, there is no other record. Oh, there is another record here. Venkat Param is another record. So we can try this. So let's open Venkat's record. So on Venkat, we can get email of the supervisor. That's good. Let's try this. So on any employee record, let's create a field, custom field called supervisor email ID. Okay, and that should be sourced from supervisor. Let's do this. Let's edit first. Customized for, oh sorry, new field, supervisor email. Okay, and then free form text. Even that might be free form text. We need to check that. Let's go to, so what I said, the criteria is both the fields should be should have same data type. So let's see email. It doesn't say whether it's a free form text or not, but let's take a guess that it's a free form text. Okay, so let's have free form text here. On employee record, we'll have this supervisor email. And display, let's insert before. What do we have here? Supervisor, insert before image. But let's see if image is available here or not. It's not available. That's fine. Only few fields are available for that insert before. Okay, what are all the insert tab? Main, okay. This is enough. So we are selecting main on sub tab, which means this field will be on the main. This is the main, your header fields, not on the under the tabs. This is the header is the main, okay. So that is under main, and let's do sourcing. First we'll get supervisor, that's how we select. Okay, we have supervisor. So from supervisor record, we need to get his email ID. Okay, got it. So from supervisor record, we're getting the email. And now we are going to save this one. The field type must match. Okay, it's an email address. Got it. Don't worry. So when you provide a wrong type, oh sorry. Why do we have test ended here? Okay, we are here, right? Okay. Let's try saving this. Okay, did we give sourcing on the correct? No, we did wrong. Oh no, we gave in the wrong. Okay. So this one applies to, and let's go here main. Okay, then sourcing filtering. Okay, from supervisor. And from supervisor, it should be email. So we created a supervisor email field on employee record. Display, we just had it normal, and subtab is main so that it will be on the header itself. Validation default is not required. Sourcing and filtering, okay. From the supervisor record, email of the supervisor record should be set in this. Now let's save this one. Okay. The field type match the type of the field you are sourcing from email address. Okay. Let's go here. Let's see if email address is present. Yeah, it's present. Okay, now it should save. Okay, it's saved. Now let's go to employee record. Let's refresh this. Okay, you can see supervisor email here. So in order to set the value, where is it sourced from? It is sourced from supervisor. So again, you need to select the value in supervisor. Only then this sourcing will work. Let's go to Zaheer. I doubt whether Prem's account has any ID. Let's do edit. So the supervisor, it is sourcing from this. First, let's remove it. Remove this supervisor. Okay. Now, when we select supervisor, okay, can you see this? The supervisor's email ID has been sourced here. So, this is called sourcing. So we create a custom field on the employee record and we are sourcing it from supervisor. So, supervisor is a record, okay. So remember, every time when you're sourcing, you should source from a record. You can't source from a field which is not a record. So if you say, okay, I want to source from currency, USA. What do you have in USA? Okay, it's not a, it's a list. USA is a list. Currency is a list, right? Your list of currencies. So it's not a record. So we need a record. So supervisor is a record. And on invoice, customer is a record. So from that record, any field value you are getting into this destination field, in our new custom field, that's called sourcing. I hope you understood sourcing. And next we have access. So make sure whenever you create a field, always have the default access level edit, and default level for searching also edit. Never change this. Only if you have any specific requirement from the client, from user, saying, hey, I don't want this field to be edited by anyone, it should always be viewed only, then you can come here. When you're creating, you can select access level only view. Okay, so I told you what you create here applies to display, where you'll set it, validation and defaulting, if you want to default it, then sourcing if you want to source it from anywhere. Let's remove this. Access, if you want to edit or just view. And after all this, there's one more thing, apply to forms. So here we selected employee form, okay, employee record. There might be like multiple employee forms, right? NetSuite provides one standard. From that one standard, we create many, right? But we may use only one preferred form. But still, we have like 3 to 4 employee forms, custom employee forms. So that's why we need to get into this apply to forms. So we see there are two forms currently, Ramsey employee form and custom employee form. So we have two forms. If you don't come into this, it will automatically select for all the employee forms. But if you want to create a field specifically for one particular form, not for all forms, for example, you're creating for sales order, you want it to be on only one sales order, not all sales orders, then you certainly need to come into this apply to, and you need to uncheck all, or you can do unmark all and select only those form you want to be. And over here we have one more feature. We can even change the label. For example, here the field is test end date, right? This is on employee record. So on employee record, I don't want this to be seen as test end date. You want some other name. For example, you don't want it test end date. You want to say it as project end date. Remove this. Project end date, and you save it. It was test end date, right? Okay, let's see. Test end date. Actually, where was it created? Let's see. Was it under custom? Need to get into it again. Test end date. Where is this? It's an employee record. Displays normal. Subtype is access. Okay. Let's go to access. Test end date. Okay, this is the field, right? Test end date. Okay, what is this form? We need to know that. Did we change for the project end date? So it changed. So that's the same. So over here you see the field name as test ended, but when it comes inside on the field, on the record, it's not test ended, it's project ended because you changed it. Where did you change it? You didn't change it on the record definition itself. You didn't change it on the customized form. You changed it at the apply to form section on the field. Okay. So this is how you create a field and all the options available on the field record. So what are different types of fields? We've seen entity fields are nothing but those we create on customer, project, vendor, employee and all. And what are other fields? Let's see. So we have item fields. Let's see what item fields. Click on any item field and then we'll see, okay, these, okay, fields, item fields are nothing but inventory item fields, non-inventory item fields, service items, other charge items, group items, kit package, assembly items. So these are just item fields, item level. You might see, you might think, what are all these inventory, non-inventory? Under lists, under accounting, under items. You have all the items that your company has, like Honeycomb has all these items, okay? So within these items, there might be different types, like some may be inventory items, some may be non-inventory items. How do you know that? Within the on the item record itself, you'll get to know. Over here, you'll have somewhere where it says what kind of item it is. Maybe this, it's not selected here, but some field, like some item description or something will be there, where it will be defined, like what field it is. Or see here, you can see at the top, this is an inventory item, okay? There's a field somewhere where it is selected as inventory item. So it is an inventory item. So certainly we have different kinds of items. What are the different kinds of items? Inventory, non-inventory, service, other charges. If you want to know what it is, what is an inventory item, just click on it. Or there's nothing, there's no information. So you need to Google it. What is an inventory item? Obviously, name suggests it's an inventory you have in stock. That's inventory. Non-inventory, you don't have stock. For example, it says it might be a software. So you won't have software in physical. So it's on, it's all digital. So those all come under non-inventory items. Service items. Service is maintenance service. Like something you'll be paying, you'll be getting, like you're providing service every month. Other charge, group, kit, assembly. So these are different kinds of items. So when you're creating item field, you can select on which item record you want that field to be. Okay, then what are other items? Okay, we have CRM fields. Let's see what are CRM fields. Let's open one. So CRM fields are fields that are created on task, project task, manufacturing operation task, phone call, event, case, campaign, solution, and all this. So these are CRM tasks. And trust me, you'll be creating very few, very, very few, or you may even not create any CRM fields within NetSuite. So what are the transaction body? Okay. What are transaction body fields? Where are they created? Name suggests transactions. So what are your transactions? Both your process, you have order to cash, you have prepare to pay. And what all forms you have in all those? Order to cash, you may have opportunity, quote, you may have sales order, invoice, item fulfillment. Under procure to pay, you will have requisition, you have purchase order, you'll have again invoice there, you'll have bill, credit, payment, all those. So those are all transaction forms. You can see here. Purchase, sale, opportunity, journal, expense report, web store, transfer order. These are all item receipt, item fulfillment. These are all transactions. So you have to just select on which transaction form you want this field. And rest all the same, just selecting the, don't forget about the type, what kind of field you want to create, what kind of value should be in that. You'll have all checkbox, currency, date, date time, decimal number, document, email address, freeform text. So freeform text is mostly used, so when you just, you're not sure what kind of data will be there, you can just leave it for freeform text. And rest all are same, display, validation, defaulting. See here, this field has some help. Help, okay, there's some description. There's a customer phone number from the customer record. It is generated dynamically every time the form is accessed, so that changes in the customer record will be reflected the next time. The transaction is viewed later on printer. Okay. So everything same, sourcing, filtering. See this sourced. Customer phone is sourced from entity. So entity is nothing but the customer. So entity, so this, where is this applied on? See this applied on sales order. So on sales order, we have customer field, right? So from the customer record, on the customer record, there'll be a phone number, phone field. So that phone field value is sourced onto this customer phone field, which is on sales order. Let's see if this is on sales order or not. It says sale, but under this sale we have sales order invoiced. Let's see what on sales form. See, under sale we have bill, credit, bill payment, cash refund, cash sale. These are all sales forms. So under this invoicing, we have invoice, item fulfillment, there is an opportunity. So when you select sale, what are all sale forms in this? It gets all those get selected. So it's not like these are all sale forms. Only those which are selected are sales forms. So under that, see we have written organization, we have sales order. So if you want any field to be set created on only particular form, like for example, you want this field only on this cash sales sort of form, then what you do? Just unlock all and then come down on the form, just select and save it. That's it. And remember, you can even say change the label from here too. It will be a good test. If you want to test someone in NetSuite, just change the name here and ask him, hey, show me where did I change the name. We'll get to know whether that guy knows how much depth in NetSuite he has or not. Okay. So that's transaction body fields. And next we have some other fields. Let's see what are those. Column fields, we'll see next. Sure. Yeah.
Hello, Sean.
Yeah.
Small doubt.
Yeah.
Record is parent.
Yeah, you'll get to know that. Yeah. You'll get to know that. That you'll get to know. When you'll get to know, you'll get to know in your custom records. Okay. That's why I didn't tell anything about it. Okay. Over here for the normal custom fields, don't worry about it. You can see it's already grayed out. Okay. It's already grayed. You can't select a value. Okay. So that we'll get to know in on custom records. Only on custom records we will use that field. Other than that, we'll never use it. Okay. We'll not use it on any fields that we create on all these forms. Okay. Good question. Next, let's see what are other fields. Column fields, we'll look next. That's our next topic. Item number fields, what are these? Let's see. We already seen item fields. And it says item number field. Okay. There's only one field. Let's select it. What is it? Where is it applied to? It's applied to specific items. Wow, okay. I've never seen such kind of type. Okay, this is first time I'm seeing too. So NetSuite also has this feature. You can have item number field, so specific items. So these are all items, right? Okay. So you can have a field for specific item record. Wow. Okay. That's digging much deeper. So normally we have on a transaction record, right? On all sales order records. Now on a particular sales order you want a field. Okay, I don't know whether we can have on sales order. I don't think that's available. It's only on item. So that means we've seen, okay, a field can be created on any item type record. But now we are saying, okay, a field can be created only for one particular item record. One particular item. So that's here. Okay. Everything should be same. Display, validation, sourcing. I've seen something. Allow delete of list record values. What is this? Help, this is, see here, helper, this is coming soon. For now, click help or use the prefix help in the global search field above. So let's go by the name itself. Allow delete of list record values. So here we have list by record values, okay, which means, okay, this is our next topic again. We didn't do custom lists, right? Okay, we first directly jump into custom fields, okay, custom lists come later on, okay. So when you get to know about custom lists, that's when, okay, or else let's get to know what are custom lists. Okay, on a field, we have different kind types of values, right? Over here, we have checkbox, currency, date, time, decimal number, document, email address. These are just simple, plain, one-line values. What if we have drop-down? For example, when we, is something open? Okay, this is open. We have drop down. See here, subsidiary. We have all these lists. What is this type, this data type called? This is called list. So, or in just when in you can say drop down, but it's a list. Okay. Just in talking terms, we'll say drop down. But what is this data type? This data type is called list. So subsidiary is a list. So these are all the values in the list. Okay. So where is that list? Even for those lists, we have standard lists and custom lists. Okay. So we're creating a field here. We are selecting list by record, and under list by record, these are all the lists available now in this Honeycomb instance. So out of this instance, some may be standard, some may be custom. Let's see where are standard, where are custom. Over here, I've shown you accounting lists. These are all standard lists. Accounting lists, filters, what are different types? We have vendor category, pricing term, terms. So these are all standard lists. We can add values to standard lists. It's nothing like we can't add values. We can add values certainly. But it's a pre-built field. That's why it's called standard field. So for example, take term. Okay, term is a standard field, so it has these values. You can certainly add new value to it. You can, 9, net 15, net 30, net 60. You can create something called net 90, so 90 days. So there's already net 90. You can create net 45 then. Net 45. So, go to list. See here, we created net 45. So there's a standard list where we can add more values. Okay. It always comes with some standard values too. Like these are all standard values. I don't think anybody created it manually. These all came with came pre-built. So well, we're adding values to it. So this is a standard list. And what is a custom list? Custom list is something which we create. Anything, and it can be any list. Like students in this session, we can create a list and we can have all your names. It's like that. So where are our custom lists situated or located in this NetSuite? So customization. List records and fields, we have lists here. So this is where we have all the custom lists. You can see the heading, it says custom lists. So these are all our custom lists, everything. So what is a custom list? How does it look like? Just open any. You have colors. Look at this. Okay, colors is a custom list. Okay, just give a name, any ID, or if you don't want to give an ID, it's fine. And then you just need to give values. Okay, list name is colors and values. Keep giving values. Make sure all the time you have this checked, order enter, or else you have option of alphabetical order too. You can enter any ways, and if you select alphabetical order, when you click on save, it will automatically place all this, sort all this in alphabetical order. And over here you can see, currently it is alphabetical, no it's not, because B is here, and B is internal ID is 5. If it was alphabetical order, B blue would have been the first value and internal ID with 1. It's like that. Actually, B L U is B L A. So black would be first. Anyways, blue would be number 2. Okay. So this is a custom list. So we can create whatever list you want, and that list you can set it any field by selecting list by record and that field and that list. You may think list, right? What is record? So it's not only a list. You can also add a custom record to a field. What's a custom record? We'll certainly look into it later on. We have a custom record next, coming up next. So we can even add a custom record to a field, just remember that. Okay, so we've seen item number field, which is specific to an item. Thanks to item number field, we even looked at custom lists. What are custom lists? It's nothing but a list of values which we can place in a field. Okay, next, there was one more field. What is this? Other custom fields, okay. Let's see what are other custom fields. Okay, we have few here. Email, okay. Where is this applying to? Well, this is not applied to anywhere. Who created this? Prem might explain us. Where is this field applied? Okay, let's check. Record type, department. Oh, see? Okay, so this apply to department. You might think, what is department? So, department is also a standard thing. You go here, company. And the company, you can see here, departments. So every client will have this. You'll have subsidiaries and you'll have departments in each and every project of yours. Unless if it's a small company operating only within a small geographical area. But most of the clients that you'll certainly work on, they'll have a lot of subsidiaries, a lot of departments. What are subsidiaries? Subsidiaries nothing but, for example, you're working on for Honeycomb. And Honeycomb does business all over the world. So what will be its subsidiaries? US, Canada, Brazil, India, Africa, Pakistan. These all will be all the countries, all the subsidiaries. So those are subsidiaries. Subsidiaries are locations where the company operates and does business. And what are departments? Departments are internal. Like you have your IT department, you have your HR department. Let's see what departments we have in Honeycomb. We have admin, engineering, R&D, HR, IT, marketing, production, services, sales. And what subjects do we have? Let's say that. So we have Honeycomb Australia, Honeycomb Canada, Honeycomb France, Honeycomb Germany. Just to let you know, Honeycomb doesn't have all this. These are created by our guys who were testing, who were just creating this as part of their assignment. And talking about assignment, you guys will get your assignment in a day or two, your first assignment. Okay, where are we? We are looking at the field, the department created by Mr. Prem. Where is it? Okay, no problem. Let's go to it again. Other custom fields, we have quite a few. Let's see some other field. Max volume. Alex Wolf Cricket, okay. So this is on bin. Wow. Where is bin? Select the type of record you want to place this custom field on. Okay. There is a bin. Bin is a record. Let's see what is. Where is bin record? I don't know about that. Company. Do you have bin here? No, you just have subject, department, locations, and classes. So that's a mystery. So where is this bin record type? Maybe it's just a record, custom record. Let's see if it's a custom record. But if it's custom record, you won't have it here. It should be on standard records. See, it doesn't start with bin. Starts with yes. We have bin. No, there's no bin. So it's a custom record. So it's a standard record. So we need to find out. If you guys have some time, just search for the record type bin, where it is. And yeah, might be. You can just check it. Let me know if you guys find it out. Just let me know where it's been. It should be a standard record. So, yeah.
I have a small doubt.
Yes.
In custom list,
okay.
Actually, there is an option called matrix option list.
Oh, really? Let's see.
On custom list.
Okay. Matrix option list. What is this? Check this box to make the list available on matrix items. Okay. If you check this box, a unique abbreviation is mandatory for each list value. Yeah, matrix, like, it says even abbreviation. So, for example, countries. You can have a country's list where you can have abbreviation for India, IND, for United States of America, you can have USA. But trust me, in my 5 years of experience, I've never created a matrix option list. So. Is it Prem?
Matrix item is completely different. Actually, it is like if you have rows, simple. If you have same model with a different colors, that is matrix item. If you go to any store, that is based on books and colors or different sizes with the different companies. Like it's 9x9 matrix or 6x6.
Yeah, yeah.
That is the way matrix item is called.
That's all. That's
it. Exactly. If you check this box, this list is available on matrix for your kind information.
Okay, guys.
If you check this box.
Okay, guys. You can do. Yeah, we don't have time. We have only 1 hour. We can do this argument later on. Yeah, just it's a good thing. It's a good
information.
Yeah, it's a good thing. Just try to create some matrix option lists and see how it works. So, yeah, that's a good idea. Just create and see how it works. Just create a matrix option list and select it in any field and see how it works. Okay? And you can also see convert to a custom record. We even have this option. Trust me, I've never used this option. By default, the order entered is checked over here. And we just gave the name of the list and just add values to it. You will have history in this. So, see this Venkat Peram has created this category. Oh no, not the category. He just created this. He added values to this category. So that's about custom lists. Okay, where were we? We were on this bin. Where is the bin? Okay, I lost the bin. Okay, let's go back to it. Customization, other custom fields. Okay. So, okay, one particular record, he created a field. Same thing, everything same. Description, the type, data type, store value, display, validations, so single filtering. Okay. So, Yeah, I don't see, I've never seen this other custom field or even the item number fields. This is something new, I guess. You can just practice it. It's a good thing, even I'll give an assignment to create such fields. Okay, so we're done with custom fields. So let's look at custom transaction column fields. Okay, these are all fields and body fields, and we have column fields. What are column fields? It's pretty simple. Let's go to in, okay, we have a journal over here. Let's look at journal. Okay, I have a meeting in 15 minutes. So all the fields over here, these are all fields, body fields. Okay, what are column fields? Column fields are nothing but these columns. Under lines, you have all these columns: account column, debit, credit, memo. If you go to any invoice, sales, enter, create invoices. On the invoice, you have, these are all fields. Okay, these are all body fields. Okay, then these are columns. Under items, you have this item column, quantity, units, description, price level, price, amount, location, options. Okay, these are all columns. So in these columns too, we have standard columns and we have custom columns. So standard columns, there is no way to go and look. You can just look it on the forms. They're just visible over here. Because as I showed you, what did I show you? Setup, I showed you accounting list, right? We have standard list over here, standard fields. But for standard columns, there's no place to search. So by default, there are only few columns. So that's why on whichever record it's suitable, we have those on those records. So these are invoice record. We have, these are all the columns. And to this, we can add custom columns. There might be some custom columns. You can see Abbas tested, it's a custom column. Let's see where is Abbas tested. Customization, list, records and fields, and transaction column fields. So if you come under this, oh wow, first one is Abbas tested. Okay, so this is a column Abbas tested, and everything is same again, similar to fields. You have an internal ID, owner, description, the type, again the same thing. You can even add a list over here. You should see list by record here. And then once you do practice all these values, you see what kind of values are set if you select each one of those. And then you have applies to the same thing. Expense, purchase, sale item, open, because it's on transaction. So columns you'll have find only on transactions. You won't find columns on entities like customers or vendors or employees, and you don't find it on CRM or some other. In NetSuite currently, CRM means all the tasks, events, calendars. So you might know say other CRMs, so don't mistake with that. Okay, so transaction column fields are only applied to transactions such as expense, purchase, sale items, opportunity store, journal, work order, and again same display, same thing, validation and defaulting, same. If you even have maximum length, okay, if you put a length of 30 and someone is trying to enter a, oh sorry, this is date, okay, forget about date. If it's just any bus test field, okay, it's not a date value, it's a freeform text. Okay, I didn't select freeform text, right? Was it selected by me? Let me see. But it doesn't make sense if he selected, oh wow, his label is Abbas test date, but his type is freeform text. Never do that. If you are saying date in the label, make sure it's always a date field. So it always has to be a date or date or time. Okay, it should always be date field. See, this is one more thing. It's not letting me change because this field is already having values. So this field has been created. Where is it created? On sales item, maybe on sales order. So there might be some sales order, sales orders where this field value is already selected. Like there's something written this field value, and you're coming, you're trying to change the data type. It will not let you change. See, it says changing the custom field type will delete all the data in the existing records. Are you sure you want to do this? Think twice or thrice before doing this, because there might be data which is important, and if you're trying to change the data type, all those data will be deleted, and it will be up to you. If you are deleting any confidential production data, then you will be under scrutiny. So make sure you don't get into trouble. So that's why when you're creating a field, make sure you select the correct data type by creating the field itself. Okay, and everything else same, display, validation, sourcing, filtering, access, everything same. So this is transaction column, and the same thing even under even for columns, you can just change the columns up and down. Where are we? Where is the invoice? Okay, you can just change, you can just move the columns can move anything up and down. You know that I told you in the last class. You could customize form. Open your own invoice. So under customize form. Why are they taking time? Let's close. Okay. Under this, under screen fields, you'll have columns at the end. Under columns, you have all this. Even here, you can change the label. So you have location. You can change the location to, you can say it's a place or something. You can change the label and you can move it. How do you move it? Double click and okay. Click on it and just move it. Click on it and just move it. Okay. So you can play with it. Cancel. So that's custom for columns. Okay. And custom columns are only on transactions. Okay, and there's one more thing I want to show you guys. Okay, let's see if that works in this instance or not. Transaction, okay, invoice, right? Let's go to list. There is one thing when you're scripting, when you're doing developing, okay? As I told you, whenever your script is trying to access a field, you'll access it by internal ID. You will never access it using the label. Always by the internal ID. Custom fields, custom columns, certainly you want internal ID, go to customization, look at, go here, if it's a transaction body field, get in there, column, get in there, you'll see the internal ID. But you might think, okay, what if, how do you find the internal ID for a standard field, a standard column? Well, let me show you that. Okay, we are on this invoice. Let's try this. I doubt that it works or not. Let's see. 10%. Actually, I need to click edit first. This nobody has taught me. I just have seen someone in the this. 10% XML equal to true. Yes, it works. Okay. So if you want to see a standard field internal ID, just do this. Click edit the form. Add ampersand XML equal to T, okay, and then you'll get everything in this XML format. Over here, you should be seeing the internal IDs. Look here, look, you can see here cust body, okay. So this is a custom form. Look here, currency. So this is standard field, and its internal ID is currency. Coupon code, its internal ID is coupon code, okay. So you can, these are all under the tags, these are all internal IDs. It's not the label name, it's all internal IDs. Okay. So under here you can find, if you don't know which field is that, you can go by the value. You can see the value, you can find the value and where is that value in between, which internal IDs, so that would be the internal ID of the field you're looking for. So remember this, whenever you want to know a standard field or standard columns internal ID, just do ampersand XML equal to T and any record and you'll get to know. Let's go back. And sometimes it's easier to find. For example, this is a standard field, right? Customer. You click on this, you get the entity. Okay, fine. For fields, it's okay. You can click on it, you'll get it. But for columns, you can't click on a column and get its internal ID. So for columns, you'll certainly have to use that ampersand XML equal to T. And then you can see what is the internal ID of the column. Otherwise, you can sometimes guess it, like description. Okay, it might be just description. Item, it might be just item, but sometimes it might be a different, for example, if it's this estimated unit cost, you cannot say estimated unit cost will be the internal ID. You need to check what it is. So here it's 110, right? Let's see what is 110. What is the value for 110? Ampersand XML equal to T. Search. Control F, where is 110? See, we have 110. So its internal ID is cost estimate rate. Okay. Cost estimate rate is internal ID. What was the label? Certainly it wasn't cost estimated rate. It was cost unit. Okay, estimated unit cost. Its label is estimated unit cost, but internal ID is what is that? Cost rate. So that's how you find the internal ID of a standard field. Don't forget that. If you're going to be a developer. If not, then fine. But I can assure you, every one of you are going to be developers in future, near future. So that's all. That's about. Go ahead.
Is this the only one way how we find this internal ID?
That's true. That's true. Yeah, of standard column fields. Standard column fields, certainly that's the only way. That's the only way. Nobody, and trust me, when I learned that, nobody taught me how to find it. Initially, when I was scripting, I was like, okay, description, it worked. Item, it worked. So when I came across fields such as this, estimated unit cost, I was like, okay, it might be estimated unit cost. It didn't work. Then I was like, oh, how do I get to know? I just went to my manager, asked him, hey, do you know this? He wasn't from NetSuite, but he has like 20 years of technical background. He just went here, he did edit, he did ampersand XML equal to T. It opened up and he said, okay, check here, you might find it. And I found it. So that's how you get the internal idea of standard column fields. But transaction, like custom column fields, don't worry. You can go to customization, go here, transaction column fields. Yeah, you have all the internal ideas.
Yeah, that one I understand.
Yeah, that's how you make use of it. Okay. So we're almost done. What did we go through today? We went through custom fields, custom columns, custom lists. Okay, let's complete custom tabs. That's a small one. It's not very big. So what are custom tabs? So on. Okay, this is a entity. Okay, this is just a field. Let's get on to any record. Transactions, sales. Okay, create invoices. You might wonder why I'm just going to invoice. I can go to sales order, but the thing is, I don't know the problem. But this instance, there's a lock on sales orders. You can't create a sales order. You can view a sales order, but you can't. I don't know the reason, but I'll show you. Enter sales orders. You should get an error. See, you get an error. So it's locked for us. You can't create sales orders, but you can. You can create. You can edit. You can just view. So forget sales orders. Just practice on other stuff that's available to us. Okay, now we are going to look at custom tabs. So you see here, these are all tabs, right? Subtabs. That's what we call it. Custom tabs. Okay, that's fine. Custom tabs or subtabs. Normally it should be called subtab, but okay, you can call even this as tabs. Okay. So what are the tabs we have? Items, billing. These are all standard. Okay. Items is standard tab. Billing is standard. Shipping is standard. These are all standard tabs. If you want to create a custom tab, look at this. RBK test. Certainly it's not a standard tab. It's a custom tab. Okay, someone of us among us must have created this. So this is a custom tab. How do you create a custom tab? Customization under forms. See, it's not tab, it's a subtab. I was right there. It's called custom subtab. See, it's not tab, because tabs are nothing but the activity, transaction. Those are all tabs. Okay, custom subtabs. Okay. Under custom subtabs, transaction, okay, for all sales order, all the purchase, all the transaction fee, transaction forms, you create the tab here. For entity, which is customer, vendor, employee, you create here any tab. See, Abbas field, Venki fields, Zahir fields, Prem fields, anything. Item, for item records, you can create a tab here. And for CRM, the calendar, estimate, all that, you can create here, okay. And once you create here, you need to go to that. Let's try to create one. Let's create whom. Zahir is there. Venki. Let's do Venkat. Venkat tab. Okay. Add. We're adding the transactions. Okay. And we're saving. And once you create a tab there, you need to go to the transaction. Like you go to sales, you go to create invoices. Okay. And then you need to go to customization, customize form. And then you have to select that. Okay. You'll find. Venkat, see Venkat tab is here. You'll select that. It should be selected, only then it will show. But after selecting this, I do cancel, but still it doesn't show. Why is it not showing? Because only if a record, only if say there's some data in it, it will be visible. So don't worry, when you create a subtab and you enable it on the custom form, you created anything, you create something here, you create any sample invoice, you save it, you don't see the tab, don't worry, because there's nothing in that. It should have some value. So it's better what you do, you move something, like any fields, move some fields onto the tab, and then certainly the tab will show up because you have fields in that. Okay. If you don't have fields, it will not show up. It's not required that you have values in that fields, but it should have fields. See, RBK test is visible because it has something here. Test RBK names, there's a sublist over here. So that's how. It's not a sublist, it's a custom record, which is connected to this as a sublist. So what's custom record? We'll look into it tomorrow. We'll get to know what's a custom record tomorrow. So that is a subtab. So hope you understood the subtab. You create subdap, enable on the custom form, and you put some fields in it. That's when it shows up. Okay. So let's wind up today. It's 7. So today we've gone through custom fields, columns, lists, and subtabs. So tomorrow we'll start with custom records and see how it goes. So guys, hope you understood. But if you have any doubts, just shoot me an email and I'll respond to you back as soon as possible. Okay. Thanks guys. Thanks a lot. See you guys tomorrow.